Here it is. The Cleveland Browns team against the Denver Broncos. That's right. The Cleveland Browns team against the Denver Broncos. Go Cleveland.
Turbocharged, adventure-ready, lunch hour, dirty little secret. The Hyundai Santa Fe. It's your journey. Own it. Get 1.9% APR for 60 months on the Santa Fe, or lease for $219 a month. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
I had a lot of bad days with gout, but that one took the wedding cake. Even with medicine, my uric acid was still too high to stop painful gout buildup. Then a gout specialist told me about Krystexxa.
Krystexxa is a prescription medicine for adults with gout whose symptoms are not controlled by other gout medicines.
I learned Krystexxa quickly starts working to break down gout buildup.
Krystexxa is an infused medicine. Serious life-threatening allergic reactions can occur while taking Krystexxa. Tell your doctor right away if you have symptoms such as shortness of breath, trouble breathing, dizziness, itching, or swelling of the throat or tongue. Krystexxa is not recommended if you have high levels of uric acid without a history of gout. Do not take Krystexxa if you have a rare disorder called G6PD deficiency or favism. Before receiving Krystexxa, tell your doctor if you have a history of heart problems and all the medicines you take. Krystexxa may cause gout flare-ups, allergic reactions, nausea, bruising, sore throat, constipation, chest pain, and vomiting.
I received Krystexxa for about 6 months. Now I'm in control, not gout.
Find a doctor who specializes in gout at goutdocnow.com.
Teddy Bridgewater was a 2014 first-round pick, played 3 seasons, 4 total in Minnesota, had that terrible leg injury. 5-1 starter in 2 seasons with the Saints. Over 3,700 passing yards last year with the Panthers, a career high, and traded to the Broncos this offseason. As they continue to look for the answer post-Peyton Manning at quarterback. Johnson.
Yes! Intercepted!
John Brown was the target, and he was well underthrown. Well, no, here's John Johnson right here, and he plays this to where he's able, it looks like he's going to the middle, and they're going to be able to get it over his head, but he reads it beautifully, and when you have the end line back there, you realize you don't have to cover as much ground. So if that's middle of the field, yeah, you can take your shot. Bridgewater is trying to drop that in, and just not a very good decision on his part, and obviously not a very good throw either. Well, they had a little something going to where it looked like they might be able to come away with some points and cut this lead. Instead, the defense comes up with a big play.
Take it home, Cleveland!
Fifth interception over the last 3 games for Teddy Bridgewater. Start of the year not turning the ball over, and that narrative has changed. Here's Dearness Johnson, breaks one tackle, cuts back. And turns that into a gain of 4 as Curtis Robinson, who was just added to the active roster, is there to make the stop for Denver. You know, Dearness Johnson, you talk about him, and if you're not a Browns fan, you probably don't know much about him just because he hasn't had too many carries, but he's out of South Florida, and he was an undrafted free agent in 2019. On his pro day, he ran a 4.8 40. There are linemen, a lot of linemen, that run faster than that. And so that's one of the main reasons why he went undrafted. Trust me, he is much faster than 4.8. He's showing it. He's a yard short of the first down as the Broncos continue to dominate the line of scrimmage. Here's a little more. He played in the AAF, was second in rushing yards and total yards. And then last year in that game against the Cowboys in Arlington, had 13 carries of 95 yards. Yeah, he started out, he signed with the Saints, and then he got released at the end of camp. He was actually in Key West working on a fishing boat trying to catch Mai Mai that year. And he hooked on with the AAF, like you said, and ultimately he landed with the Cleveland Browns in a good spot to be. First down. Hooked on. What did you mean to say that? Well, he's catching Mahi Mahi, and then he hooked on.
Will you be impressed if I said yes?
Yeah, I would be more.
Yeah, then no, I didn't mean to say that.
He's looking good tonight, though, isn't he? Went to Immokalee High School, which is where Edgerrin James, a Hall of Famer, went about a half hour or so east of Maple. John Kelly, former Ram, who was just activated. Without Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt, it's Dearness Johnson, Johnny Stanton, the fullback, Dimitri Felton, and John Kelly. Well, they're 4 deep right now, and they're running right through this defense. 87 rush yards already. Hand off to Kelly. Let's go down to Aaron Andrews.
Joe, you mentioned Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt not being in the lineup. This is the first time in a while.
Whoa.
I know one of those have been in the lineup, and I did
speak
to Dump Mitchell about it, and he goes, yeah, finally.
How on earth did he keep a full head of hair?
I'm looking forward to it tonight. But he said it's been about 7 years since he's had an all-pro in the lineup, and he loves every minute of this, kind of reiterating to these running backs in there, you're on our roster for a reason. Now go show it.
good point, Aaron. A short week, and you can imagine that there were some late nights for Stunt Mitchell and getting some of these up to speed. That should be a false
start. Whoa! Fiddlesticks.
For people of a certain age who grew up in St. Louis, Missouri, watching the St. Louis football Cardinals, as we called them back in the day, that guy was beloved.
He had a really
good pro career. He's been a coach for a long time now. Had a great career. Wonderful guy, too. Dimitri Felton checks in as Jim Kelly checks out. Second and 13. Tomorrow morning on NFL Network, wake up with Good Morning Football. They'll recap tonight's game and preview all of Sunday's action. Good Morning Football tomorrow at 7 live on NFL Network. I tell you, those guys do a great job on that show. I watch them just about every morning, all of them. I just think they're awesome, and I know that Nate Burleson went on to, I'd say, greener pastures, but it's pretty green there in the studio on Good Morning Football. But keep up the great work, everybody.
Yeah.
I echo those same thoughts. Third down and 13. Needham going to air it out. And nearly picked. Sertan was back there defending Anthony Schwartz. It's fourth down, and there was just nothing there. I know you love Pat Sertan.
Well, I sure do.
I mean, he looks the part. I mean, this
come
guy,
on, Cleveland Brown.
6'2", 200 pounds. He has great length. He can fly. Yeah, there was a talk, of course, me living in Dallas. Dallas thought that they would be able to draft him, that they would have the best corners. Can you imagine those two, first of all, playing together at Alabama, and if Trayvon Diggs and Pat Sertan were on the same NFL team? Not sure anybody could believe that.
Oh. Damn.
Good coverage by the Browns downfield after a 43-yard punt. All right, back on offense. The Broncos coming off that pick last time they had it down 10.
To live is to ask.